artist Kanchan Chandru with us today at the Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy. Kanchan is going to share with us 35 years of a journey as an artist, in which she has chronicles the vast amount of work and experiences in the field of art. She's also taking a workshop with the students of the Government College of Art, working with them in new media techniques and also encouraging them to think more about ideas and how to execute them. We speak to Kanchan about her journey. Hi.
Hi.
Welcome to Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy.
Thank you. Thanks.
So, Kanchan, today you will be sharing with us the journey of 35 years. How would you look back at your life and at these 35 years? Of course, they come with a host of experiences. And how do you look at it?
It's been a beautiful journey, and there have been, I've met such beautiful people. I've interacted with youngsters, a lot of youngsters while I was teaching, and it's been a big roller coaster ride. You know, there have been ups and downs in life, and I think on the whole it's been quite interesting and wonderful.
Okay. And where did it all begin? At home, at school?
It began with my father was a diplomat, so I traveled a lot with him to various countries, and also as a sibling, my sister used to go for art classes wherever he was posted, and I used to accompany her. And when I would go, I would get very frustrated coming back and not being able to paint like she was. She used to do so academically and nicely. It's just that I went on practicing, and later on my art teachers pointed out and appreciated my work, and they would hold up a painting of Holi in the third class, and he said, "This is a beautiful work," and I said, "That's mine, that's by Kanchan." So, and from there onwards, I think I got appreciation from my art teachers in the school, and art was always my, which I always carried on.
Okay. And so from the very beginning, from so early on, you knew that this is what you're going to pursue?
Yes, from that time onwards, I of course wanted to do English literature, but the teacher was not very, I was not her favorite. So she failed me, and I think it was probably a blessing in disguise.
Absolutely.
Total blessing in disguise.
And there was support from home? Because at that time things were different.
Support as far as my college was concerned, yes. And then my father started getting very jittery that she is going to be a full-fledged artist and she should continue as a hobby.
Yes.
And I kept correcting him and saying it's not a hobby, it's a profession. So there was support in the sense that, but he was not happy that I should continue as a artist. He wanted me to do the calendar art, you know, that beautiful sceneries and landscapes. And every time he would see my work, he says, "Who's going to buy this?" You know, all that. But I was very, very adamant, and I continued with my art.
And what were the influences at that time? 30 years back, you were studying abroad as well as in India. So it must have been varied influences, especially when you study abroad. Are things extremely different from what is being taught here?
See, when I was, I did my first year in Kunst Hochschule Berlin, and there, the academic, the drawings and all are so perfect that I was almost the last one there. But when I came to India, I turned out to be the topper. So you can see the level of their perfection in drawing. The Germans are really good. I mean, they also have the Bauhaus time time. So there were influences like that. There were influences of the museums I used to visit. I was a constant visitor to all the art galleries, museums. There have been different influences. There was Van Gogh at one time, later on Amrita Shergill, David Hockney, Washington. I mean, there were different phases, different influences coming in, and one can see it somehow reflected in some of my earlier works.
So what were you painting earlier, when back in college or soon after you passed out? Was it very different from, has the work evolved with you as a person, or with the change of
work? I strongly believe in the evolution of an artist, his works, because I feel that if you're making an apple, you just can't go on making an apple. This is my philosophy. So my earlier works are totally different to what I do now. And to a certain extent, they're a little bit autobiographical, because it depended on what went on in my life, what was going on around me. When I was in college, I lost my only brother. So of course, then a lot of big series was based on that, and then it was started being based on women issues. I wasn't a feminist, but I wanted to. I was always sensitive towards the atrocities and issues of women. So a series was based on that. And from there onwards, it's departed. But when I left college, I was doing printmaking in the Gari studios, because we didn't have studios at that time to paint at home. So a little bit of painting at home. And as life went on, as I got married and as I had a kid, it was impossible to go
out
to the studio. No, I was working. I had a full-time job. Mm. I had a full-time job. I had old parents to look after. And it was difficult to do printmaking, because printmaking is very tedious and it's very time consuming. So then I started doing painting. So today, I mean, printmaking is very dear to my heart, but it's not of that level that I would love to do.
Right, right. And you also do sculptures as well as drawings.
Yeah.
So when from printmaking to painting and then sculptures?
Sculptures I did in between. I've worked in fiberglass, I've worked in aluminium, in steel. So as and when, sometimes it was a show which happened in the stainless steel, had organized an exhibition. It was curated by Alka Pandey. So they invited me, and then we did a collaboration with the Jindals.
Steel.
And we worked in Manesar, so that was a big challenge. So I got a few commission works after that. So sculptures at time, more paintings, and in the last many years, I've been working on mixed media. It's something which is very dear to my heart. In fact, all mediums are. I love printmaking, painting, mixed media. It's just that there are phases. There are phases when you concentrate more on prints or on painting or in mixed media. So it's been like the phases.
And in the painting, you work a lot in the feminine form, and also the assertion, the power of women, and you also link it with mythical elements as well, and also the mother and child relationship. Mm. So tell us a little in detail about where these works emerge from.
Well,
do you portray them? I mean,
the mythical is because when I travel, I do a lot of documentation, I take a lot of pictures. So my trips to Konark or Khajuraho, or you know, any temple I go to, I take pictures of the, you know, the female forms. I love the Lavanya, you know, it's the Tribhanga pose.
Yes.
So that has inspired me. There's been a series, total series based on that, on these sculptures. Then, like what I said earlier, that the women issues have been, is something which has been, which has inspired me, but I've not gone out on the streets and shouted.
No.
That, you know, blah, blah, blah. But my thing was, my revolt was to do it silently through the art. So I have had her in, when you see the lecture, you'll see that, you know, the forms are the woman sort of like encrouched or sitting in a pose where she's got lots to say, but she can't speak. There's a beautiful print I made, which was the title of which is Incarnation of Tolerance. By the title given by Rabindranath Tagore, because she is an incarnation of tolerance. And then later on, I also did on, when my son was born, on the Vatsalya series, mother relationship. But like I said, it's autobiographical. A lot of work depends on what is around me. So my son, while he was growing up, and all those things got into it.
Okay. So this is a constant process.
It's a constant process.
Right.
I can't really sort of.
Yeah.
It's like you can say that series, then this series, and now it's more. Presently, it's more on the. I'm back to the torsos. I was known for my female torsos.
That. So tell us a little about that, and you're also embellishing this as well with the brighter colors and sometimes sequins and.
My earlier works were very browns and blues. It's like, I think as one is young, one likes those colors. One likes the color of death, one likes the color of, subtle colors. But I think as I grew older, my works became more vibrant, the colors became more powerful, more vibrant, and the works became more, you can say, maybe whimsical. And the embellishment started, it started earlier, but it really started in 97, when I was traveling to States. I saw a beautiful show by Robert Rauschenberg, in fact his retrospective.
Okay.
And I came back and I started using these sequins and beads, and I started working on a series of torsos, female torsos. Now, earlier I was making full figures with the face and arms and legs, but here I didn't want to identify the woman. I didn't want to know whether it's you or me.
Okay.
I just wanted to take the full form because it's a universal issue. So I just worked on the female torso forms. I bedecked her with sequins, Swarovskis, laces, paper cuts, wrapping paper, whatever I find. So if you come to my studio, you'll find boxes and boxes of sequins and all these things. And I know exactly where is what. It's a total sort of chaos there. So those things I've embellished, and over the years now the embellishment has become very very intricate. And I love working on it because I feel it's very therapeutic and it's very meditative. Like I said, the turmoil life I had, now I've come at peace, and I'm like, I just want to live the way I want to live, with my own way, and I'm totally engrossed in working.
So what do the female torsos depict, or what do they say to you as an artist, and what do you want to say to your...
It's a lot jumbled up. It's a woman, it's the sensitivity in her, the motherhood, the fertility, sensuousness, the times to, like, I feel that every woman has a Durga in her and has a Kali in her. She is quiet and subtle, and at the same time she can be like a Kali if she has to protect her her family or her child, so I have done a series on that also, the Durga and Kali.
It's called
the Durga in me and the Kali in me. So it's that's what I want to depict through her.
Okay. And is there a lot of influence from the tribal paintings or motifs in these series, of the female
Not
form?
Now. Not Earlier, now. Yes.
Earlier,
there was a lot of influence when I was working on the sculpture series. There was a lot of because I had traveled to places like Bastar, and whenever I traveled, I would pick up blocks, or I would take pictures, and it would sort of come into my work.
Right. You talked a little about new media and how it is really the center of your work now. So in context of that, also you did a lot of study on contemporary art when you were moving abroad and on scholarships, etc. So talk to us a little about contemporary art, because you were also a teacher.
Yes, that was, I think I was little ahead than my other colleagues, because I, when I was teaching in College of Art at that time, about I think almost 20 years back, I did one workshop where I made them do site-specific works, and in those days very few colleges in India were doing, maybe little bit of Baroda or some, but in Delhi College of Art it was something new. The students just freaked out, they loved it. There was a little bit of as usual, objection from some of the colleagues and some of the senior artists who said, yay, what is all this she's doing? But I was thinking that this is what we are going to head towards. And today,
this
I'm talking
exactly.
about 20-25 years back, today this is exactly what is happening. There is this multimedia, there's performance art, this site-specific work, installations, all that is there. So because I was aware, I was traveling a lot, I was updating about what is happening globally. I think that is that awareness I wanted to convey to my students. And you know, we would even do sort of like private workshops. I would take them to places and I said, do works there, do things. I was also associated with the, you know, the institutions, like places like Alliance Francaise or Goethe Institute in Delhi. So we would do I would do a lot of collaborative workshops with them.
Okay.
And I think I was always fond of that. I thought that it's important to move along with the times.
So has in what way do you see contemporary art as far as India is concerned as an artist, and what has changed in the last, if we may say, 10 years?
10 years. Well, a lot has changed the last 10, 20, 30 years. The young generation is very smart.
Okay.
They are really smart. They're very aware of what is happening globally, and they know what to do. They know what to do. They are good presentators. They are good at talking, which we as students, when we left, we were bhundus. We didn't know. All, if somebody would say, why have you painted there? We say, oh, you know, we painted because we like it. Please look at it. That's it.
Right.
We would say like that. But today they know. They know how to talk and present themselves. And they are a lot into multimedia, the new media. They're into video art and all these things, which is good because, you know, it is universally, it is being accepted all over the world like that. What I miss today is pure painting.
Yes.
It's very, very few who are into it, very few. But I just feel because we are 40, 50 years behind what the West was doing. West was running towards this earlier and we are doing it now. But I think, I just feel painting will come back one day.
So tell us about your work with new media art and your new media elements.
I basically am comfortable with the painting and printmaking and mixed media, but there's always sometimes an urge to, you know, I mean, I 2 years back I made a video. So it's a 4 minutes video. It's again a psyche of a woman I've tried to portray, and I'm the model. I have I've done the acting in that, and I have been working a lot on the installations.
Okay.
Not that much, but I don't do it when somebody says, I do it when I feel like.
Right.
I mean, I feel very strongly that it has to come from inside.
Right.
So I am working a little on it, not much.
Okay. Okay.
But right now it's the mixed media.
Okay.
A lot.
Okay. So what is, apart from videos, what else are you doing in, if you could share some of your latest works and your
Latest is, I'm doing again, I'm back to torsos, I said. It's again pure, it's painting. There's, that's pure painting. That's acrylic and oils. That's one. Number two is I'm working a lot on the Bollywood, Hollywood series, which I've been doing from the last 4 or 5 years.
What is that, Kanchan?
I take you know, the legends like Meena Kumari, Marlon Monroe, Marlon Dietrich, Greta Garbo, Madhubala, and I work on the Photoshop first, take out printouts and I embellish it. And that embellishment takes me a lot of time. I mean, starting from sourcing the materials, like whether it's wrapping paper or whether it's laces or sequins. I do everything myself. I go to Old Delhi. I'll pick up the stuff. When I travel abroad, I'm always looking for wrapping paper. If I get a gift, I said, forget the gift. I want to see how the wrapping paper is. So all the sourcing I do myself. So it's actually the whole process of sourcing, embellishing it, cutting the wrapping papers into small pieces of pieces of paper and then sticking it on. It's actually layering upon layering.
Okay. On the photograph print.
On the photograph.
Okay.
On the Photoshop work that I have done.
Right. Right.
And a lot of elements come on it. Button sequins, patches, you know. So it's a mixture of all. And even when I go for a walk, if I sign something on the road, if I like it, I just pick it up and, you know, sort of like I reuse it.
Okay.
A lot of things from the house, which, you know, I have old brushes. The latest work I did about a few months back, I had lots of old brushes which were like, you don't feel like throwing them. So I put it into the work.
Pin brushes.
Yeah, it's the hollow at the back. It's okay. With spoons, plastic spoons, and it's with brushes coming out from the female form.
Oh, wonderful. And these are presented as artworks. And
yeah, they are artworks. They mm-hmm. are my, I have called it the Devi Nouveau. It's a new series of Devi Nouveau. She's very contemporary. You have beer can images there. You have rum there. You have nut bowls. Then you have washers. It's all the thing. And what I'm trying to portray in this new Nouveau Devi, new Devi is that. The woman is now, I mean, there is no borderline that, you know, this is a woman's job or this is a man's job. The woman is getting into plumbing, she is doing the electrician's job, and the men are going to beauty parlors. So it's like merging. Mm. So that's what I'm trying to portray, that today's woman is a multitasker.
Right.
She's managing the home, house, motherhood and that.
Right. And so you mentioned one was the Bollywood series and one is this one. So
yeah.
These both employ new media art.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how challenging was it for you to update yourself on new techniques? And do you think it was easy because you were an artist and you had so much exposure?
I think it was easy. It's just that I look at it and I let it penetrate naturally. I don't like to impose that.
Okay.
I have to do it because everybody else is doing it. No.
No. Okay.
I mean, if I had to,
there's
then
no
I would
pressure.
Have done. No, there's no pressure. I
no.
just do what I want to do.
Okay.
People, when they see my old etching, it says, oh, you know, why don't you do something like that? I said, listen, 30 years back, I'm not the same Kanchan.
True.
I'm a totally different person. What life has made me. So I cannot do, I'm probably not as sensitive as I was 30 years back. So I can't reproduce that anymore.
True.
So today is what, that's me, what I am today.
Right.
Because I love to go out, I love traveling.
Okay.
I'm very fond, right now my agenda is only working and traveling.
Mm.
So, you know, I mean, this is what me is now. So that's what my work will be. It's totally what you are.
True.
I love colors, I love jewelry, I love life. So I want my new works to be full of life.
Full of life.
Yeah.
Oh. And of course, you also mentioned that art is not about working in isolation and it's not for art's sake alone, but it's also for others as well as how life has made you. So anything that you feel that you still haven't done which you have an inner desire to?
There are lots. Mm. There are lots. You know, I mean, I want to do this mixed medias on a very large scale.
Okay.
I want to do more installations. I want to go more into videos because I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. Last time I got it edited with a young person. This time I thought I'll edit it myself.
Okay.
So there's lots I feel. I think as an artist you can never stop. You know, it's just that, but right now, I just want to concentrate and do solid body of works, which, you know, like I said earlier, it was, you know, old parents, aged parents, child growing up and all that. So right now it's basically just focused on that.
On yourself and work.
Yeah, on the work.
Okay. And your son, you said, was an artist as well.
Yeah, he's into art. Mm. He's an artist. He studied in Birmingham. He's had his solo show, first solo, which was quite successful. He was also acting, stage actor, but now he's also directing plays.
Okay.
So he's directing plays, but his main thing is
painting.
Is art.
Okay.
Yeah. He's workaholic. He's more than what I call myself a workaholic, but I feel he's my guru when it comes to.
So when you look at him and in the field, and when you look at yourself so many years back when you were his age, What is the kind of gaps that you find? Is it easier for this generation of artists? More platforms, more art fairs, more money?
Yeah, there are more opportunities for them. That is definitely true. We had none. We just had work, and once in a while, if the work was selected in some show, we were like, wow, top of the world. The youngsters have many more opportunities. And you see, art is not only restricted to galleries now. It's come out. Young curators, young art dealers who are taking art to different platforms. They sometimes do something very nice in restaurants or in sort of like social places. Right now, he's exhibiting in a pub, which is a very new, different concept. The young curators have beautiful concepts. So you see, that is something which is challenging for them, and they are young. So their minds are young, their ideas are young. So they have different challenges, this young generation, which I say, why not? I mean, you can't restrict art only to galleries or museums, you know, because there's also public art.
Completely.
You know, you have people painting on the street art, you have people painting on the outside the facades of the buildings, you know. So it's very, very different. And I also see a reflection of me in him, because when I was his age, I was a total workaholic. Mm. So I feel that he's a painter, he's a pure painter, which I am happy, because he's not much into multimedia. He's not at all into multimedia, which is a challenge.
Of course.
Your peers are doing it, you're not doing it. But like I said, he had a successful show, so that means there is still, sort of like art lovers who like paintings.
And is your work a great influence on his work as well?
Not at all.
Not at all.
Yeah, poles apart.
Yeah.
Poles apart, you know. He's semi-abstract and very different. And I'm totally figurative.
Yes. Yes.
Which I think it's nice, because he's found his own language.
That's right. And as far as we didn't have a chance to talk about your installation work, mm-hmm. which you say that you love doing, but you take it easy and do it only when it inspires you. So if you could talk a little about your installation work.
I'll tell you about two, three of mine. One is, again, it was called Fables Retold. It was based on my relationship with my son. So it's like every mother tells a story to the child. There was a king, Ekta Raja, Ekti Rani. So I did these discs of about 7 inches diameter. It was, again, mixed media at that time.
Okay.
That was woodcuts with sequins, and then based on a lot of his homework time. So my son would very often give me his broken toys, broken parts, which I reused in the works. Like in the smaller disc, there was an arm of a G.I. Joe, which I put. Then maybe somewhere else it was a leg. Mm. Somewhere else it was maybe a small, like a ball or something. So I reused these toys, and it was a beautiful installation of 105 works. It was on this wall, and on the floor, like an L-shape. So that was one.
Okay.
Then another installation I did was, it was called Passion Possession. It's like every woman is passionate and obsessed by hoarding.
Mm.
She won't throw even a pin. She won't even throw a safety pin. So I took these plastic sachets, and in each one I put myself in her shoes, and I started putting, like, you know, anything which was in the house, a red chili, or, you know, when I went for a haircut, I went and collected my silver hair, and he was like looking at me, the person, and I started putting it in the thing. So each one of them had different things. So in some it was safety pin, chili, some turmeric, or, you know, something. And I hung them.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a string of, let's say, 30 plastics. So in each one I hung them. There were about, I think, 20 lines of them. So that was another one. And another installation was I did with, like I said, I did a lot of collaborations. I did collaborations with different artists. There was one artist from Australia called Helen Geyer. So I went there, we worked in a studio, and we did a clever thing because we had to bring the works back to India and we had to pay for our transport. So we used stuff which was like, you know, this Bukram, which you put inside the collar.
Yes.
And we used the fly net, something which was very thin. So we worked on it and we did it as scrolls, roll it up, and it traveled all over. It came to Chandigarh also.
Okay, as an exhibition.
Yes, there was a gallery called Art Folio.
Yes, yes.
So
yes,
it was done there.
Okay.
So it was a collaboration. So in two tubes, we took the works all over. We were both women, so we could think that, you know, practically this is what has to be done. So I've done things like that.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So everything from real life and around you.
Yeah, yeah. So it's always things around me, people around me. Mm. Always based on that.
Yes, and women for sure, because
women. Yes, it's always had a soft corner for that, because also my son has been brought up by three women, my mother, my sister, and me. He says, you know, it's because I was divorced and single, so he's been brought up by three women. You know,
so that influence. Okay. And you travel a lot, Kanchan. So what are the, do you also study a lot of art, what's being done outside, and does it move out of the purview of just painting, or does it also go into cinema and theatre?
Oh,
and
yes. I used to study a lot of that, but I don't study it, but I study it visually. I mean, I like to document it and keep it in my folder of, you know, the hard disk. Because I don't know when, where I'll use it, but I just like to travel to, out of curiosity, to see it. And you mentioned films. I am a total movie buff. I mean, I evenings I would go for a walk, and if I don't want to paint, I'll just open up the laptop and see a movie which is downloaded by my son and very generously passed on to me.
Right.
So I see old movies, I see the Oscar movies, and place. Like I said, I'm into a lot of things.
Right. And that's where probably the series also emerged from, the women of Bollywood and movies.
That, and plus my long hidden desire that if I was not a painter, I would have loved to be an actress.
Really?
So when my son said he wants to go into acting, I was like, wow, because it's something which I really wanted to do. And
really?
I keep saying, if you ever have a role for a mother-in-law or granny, please give it to me, you know. So I really still have a desire that one day I can act. I would love to, you know.
Really?
Yes.
So do you also work on a lot of different things at the same time, Kanchan, or do you concentrate on a series, like you said, that you're also working on torsos right now, and also on installations and new media?
I do it in series. Like, I mean, you see, now what has happened is that there has been a demand for my Bollywood, Hollywood. So that is something which is
consistent.
It's it goes on. But I'm concentrating more on my paintings right now.
Okay.
There might be a time where I might just say, okay, I don't want to do painting. I can't do everything at the same time.
Okay.
No, it's like, I would say it's like phases. You know, it's a phase for painting. Installation, maybe there's a phase. Like I said, I mean, I'm itching to go back to video. And you see, video is something which you can do simultaneously also. Like when you're traveling, you're shooting. It's when the editing and all comes that you have to sit.
And it must be quicker also, Kanchan, as opposed to doing a painting or a sculpture? Video?
No. For me, it's a new media, so it takes time. But I would like to go further into it.
Okay. But do you work every day consistently?
I am in my studio every day. If you call that work, you see, even when you're sourcing something, that's work.
Right.
You know, when you're traveling, you're taking pictures, that's... I don't sort of say that I don't have to actually hold a brush and, you know, do it every day.
No.
There are days when I just work for 7-8 hours. There are days when I just don't feel like working. But I would say that I like to work.
Right. And do things change while you're working, in the sense that you think of something and you begin a painting or a subject, but while you're doing that painting, does a lot change?
This does happen, especially in paintings, that you start with something and then, you know, you don't like it and you erase it and you go back. But in my case, you can say that 85-90% I'm sure of what I'm doing.
Mm.
I'm usually, because I don't start till I'm sure.
Mm.
But of course, there have been times when it doesn't work out and I rework on it. And believe me, all my reworked works are, you know, quite nice. It's probably that, you know, it turns out to be better.
And the feminine form is a consistent or a constant in your work?
That's
it, that. It may be in any form. It could be a painting or a video.
Yeah. That has been there, which has been there.
Okay. And incidents around you, of course, especially regarding women, form the basis of these works mostly?
Yeah. That is always there.
And have things changed a lot in the last, you've been working on the status of women, has it changed a lot over the few
what
years?
What way?
Back then, 30 years back and now, well, as far as artists are concerned.
Artists is different, but I'm talking about the general mindset of people.
That
is, it's not changed. You know, they might look very modern and all, but the mindset still has to be changed. It's very sad, you know, it's very sad. Artists are, you know, I think they are all very professional now, and that's it.
So are your parents happy that you took up art finally, and
unfortunately, my father passed away 15 years back. He was happy before he went. My mother passed away last year. So they were happy. You know, he was always confident that this girl, I don't have to worry about her. She'll manage on her own.
So it's been a great journey for you.
It's been a beautiful journey.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Bye.